Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. Soil is the literal foundation for much of life, yet we treat soil like, well, like dirt. Maybe that's because most of the time, soil takes care of itself. Decomposing plants and animals and degrading bedrock produce new soil at roughly the same pace that wind and water eroded away. But this balance between soil formation and erosion is easily tipped. For millennia, the tiny Pacific island of Mangaia was covered in a thin layer of fertile soil. But after humans arrived around 2,000 years ago, their slash-and-burn agriculture exposed the soil to the elements. Over several centuries, rain and wind swept virtually all the nutrient-rich topsoil from Mangaia's hillsides and concentrated it in just a few arable valleys, which people viciously fought over. With less land to grow crops, people resorted to alternative food sources like rats, and even each other. We're doing the same thing throughout the world today. Not the part where we eat each other, but the part where we farm the soil away. That's because we make room for agriculture by clearing away deep-rooted native vegetation, and we use hose, plows, and tractors to loosen the soil, making it easier for wind and rain to sweep away. And we grow mostly shallow-rooted crops that are no good at holding onto soil, and that get stripped away during harvest, leaving fields bare for much of the year and at the mercy of the elements. As a result, the world's farmlands lose soil 50 times faster than new soil can form. That extra erosion adds up to about 8 billion pickup trucks of soil moved annually from fields to places like the bottoms of rivers and behind dams, which are less convenient for farming. That soil loss reduces global crop yields by as much as if we took a California-sized swath of farmland out of production every decade. Fortunately, we know how to bring erosion back into balance with the rate at which soil forms. Plow less often, and after harvest, leave plant parts behind, or plant so-called cover crops to, well, cover the soil as protection against water and wind. We can also incorporate trees or native plants that keep soil in place year-round. Putting strategies like these in place can cut erosion by as much as 95%, helping keep crop yields high in the long run. But in the present, they can hurt yields, because adding other vegetation to farm fields means less room for crops. As a result, we've been slow to make these soil-saving strategies the norm. If we can't keep the farmable soil on our farms, human civilization won't immediately implode. But we might end up fighting over the patches of land where that soil ends up. Like the Mangaians, but on much, much bigger islands. And speaking of soil, this video was sponsored by Soylent, a line of nutritionally complete, convenient foods that actually take less soil to produce because many of their core nutrients, including omega-9 fatty acids, come not from plants grown in field, but from algae grown in fermentation tanks. Their newest product, Coffeeist, reimagines breakfast as a coffee-flavored, algae-fueled meal in a bottle to help kickstart your day. Plus, Soylent has partnered with the World Food Program USA to donate a meal to someone in need for every case of Coffeeist they sell. Go to soylent.com/earth. That's soylent.com/earth. Or click on the link in the description to get 10% off your first month's worth of Coffeeist. Thanks, Soylent.